Alright guys, so I finally found a place to go target shooting and I'm really happy. I haven't shot a gun one time since I arrived here in Kentucky. And I just want to try out my new extended magazine for my Glock 17. Let's check it out. Alright, today I'll be shooting this ZQ ammunition for the 9mm. Kind of expensive stuff. I think you're better off going with something like Winchester or Federal. I just don't see the performance of the ammunition justifying an increase in the price. It's just a full metal jacket, but the price tag is kind of steep in my opinion. But, however, it does work in a Glock, I will say that. And I'm gonna be using 45 ACP, of course. I'm gonna be using Federal, which has always been reliable for me. And to give you guys an idea, this is a standard 17 round magazine for the Glock 17. And this is what I got the other day, 31 rounds, 31 rounds of 9mm for my Glock 17. I think these things, this is a factory Glock magazine, which means Glock actually makes these things. I saw some Korean ones at a flea market, but I wanted the factory magazines. And I think this is a magazine that's used for the automatic Glock 9mm. I think it's a Glock 18, but of course since they're the same caliber, you can use them for the Glock 17s. And you know, I wish they had something like this for the Glock 21 extended magazines, you know, the whole like 20 so 45 ACP rounds, or at the very least something like a 15 round capacity, because the FN, this FN pistol I came across actually has a 15 round capacity. And of course it has a little bit of a, and that's the standard magazine, it has a little bit of a thicker one, thicker bottom base plate, but it'd be cool if Glock came out with something like that. Now this is the first time I really loaded, I'm gonna actually load this thing up, so I expect the spring to be pretty stiff. All right, there it is. I got all 30 rounds in there. Did I actually get more than 30? Oh, 31 rounds. I don't know. But yeah, the speed loader definitely makes it a lot easier. Never had a problem out of this Glock or any gun, but first time I've ever seen a pistol or a Glock stovepipe. Alright guys, I'm gonna mix it up now. I actually put 17 rounds of that ZQ ammo in there. I'm gonna use some of this old hollow point that I've had laying around. Let's see how well it does. I'm gonna actually, this time, I'm only gonna fill it up to like maybe 28 or 29. Okay, this time it was a failure to eject about halfway through the actual magazine. Now I don't know if this is just a break-in period situation with this magazine, but I don't really consider this to be something I would rely on for self-defense at this point. Now the gun's been pretty reliable with just regular magazines, but with these extended magazines, I don't know. All right guys, remember that failure to eject? Turns out it was a hollow point. It's a Remington hollow point. You know, it's interesting. I shot this ammo before and wasn't really too impressed with it. I never had a failure to feed, but I only shot like a box or two. Actually, only one box. This is the second box. And I shot it through the standard magazine, standard 17 round magazine. I didn't have any problems, but I did feel like the ejections were kind of weird. That a lot of times the brass would come right towards my face and it just shot differently than the ammo that I was used to. And I noticed with this, when I had it half full, half with a Remington, and then half with this ZQ stuff, at that halfway point, that's when I had a failure to eject. So I'm starting to think maybe it's ammunition, but maybe this ammunition isn't good to go along with this magazine right here. It may be the magazine, but I've never had a problem out of this gun with the regular Glock magazines.